Hello my dear student, welcome to Nageshkar Rasgi Orchid School channel. Myself Hina Patel, going to teach you 7th standard mathematics. Already in the previous class we had started with the simple equations. We had learned how to find out the values of variable, how to equal the equations by substituting the values of a variable. Today we will learn some more steps regarding the simple equation. Today we will see that we have seen that while solving an equation, one commonly used operation was an adding or subtracting. We had seen many examples, so you might recall what we had done in the previous class. The same number on the both the side. Already when we had started with this lesson, I had given some hints and I had given some rules what we have to follow while solving the equation. Of the equation we have to add or subtract the same number on the both the side. The transposition is the number that changing the sides of a number. This is the new word for you, that is a transposing a number is a changing the sides of a number is the same as adding or subtracting the number from the both the side. In doing so, the sign of a number has to be changed. This you should remember. When it is transposing the numbers, the sign should be changed. What applies to a numbers also applies to an expression. Let us take two more example of transposing the equation. So here we will see one simple equations what we had done here in the previous class, adding or subtracting the both the side. This you know very well because we had done a many example. 3p minus 10 is equal to 5. To find out the 3p, what we were doing, we were adding 10 to the both the side of an equation, that is LHS as well as RHS. So we had added 10 here as well as we had add 10 here to the right hand side. So this 10 get cancelled, so it will be 3p is equal to 15. Here 5x plus 12 is equal to 27. It is another example which we will see where what we do here is subtracting a 12 on the both the side, because we are having addition 12, that is a plus 12, so we have to subtract to get this as a nil. So it will be 5x is equal to 27. So we are subtracting 12 on the both the side. So this 12 get cancelled, so it will be 5x is equal to 27 minus 12 is 15. This type of equations we had seen in the previous exercise and we had tried to solve many examples related to transposing. What it is, it's very simple, it is new word. I will make you to very easy step how to solve this by transposing this. 3p minus 10 is equal to 5, same equation we are taking. Now when it is transpose means what? Minus 10 from LHS, that is we will transpose minus 12 from LHS, means it is left hand side, it will go to and right hand side, that will get into an add, that will be 10 plus. So here what will be the step? 3p is equal to 5 is equal to whatever the number we are having is equal to, then we are having a 5, write the same number 5 here. When it is transposed, so it will be minus 10 will be converted into plus 10. So 3p is equal to 15. So here also we are getting that 3p is equal to 15. Both the answer will remain same. You can use any one of the method to solve the given equation. We will see another example also. Here it is given as 5x plus 12 is equal to 27. What we have taken here, what the second example which we had solved by our method which we had seen in the previous exercise. Now we will do the transpose of plus 12, that will go as an minus 12. So what will be here? Why we are taking 5x? Because it's an variable x with a number. So we will separate it first. Phi x is equal to, we will write whatever we are having in front of equal to, that is 27. When it is transposed, so plus 12 will be changed into minus 12. That you have to remember, the sign will get changed. So here phi x is equal to 27 minus 12 is 15. So we got answer as phi x is equal to 15. So in this way we had seen that by transposing or by adding or subtracting on the both the side, the answer will remain the same. Here we are having some more example, one two example we will see, then we will go to an exercise sum. Here 4 inside the bracket m plus 3 is equal to 18. What is inside the bracket means we have to solve or we have to consider first. So here is multiplication, so when it is transposed, so it will be in the division. So we will see the step by step. Here is our equation, that is 4 inside the bracket m plus 3 is equal to 18. So let us divide both the side by 4, that what we had done in the previous exercise. Yes, to get m plus 3 separately with a variable separately, we are going to divide because here we are having a multiplication. So both the side by 4, so what will be this? M plus 3 is equal to 18 divided by 4, or we can say m plus 3 is equal to 9 upon 2. What it is? Here in the first, here in the left hand side, 4, 4 get cancelled. So I had not considered here. So we write as what we are having with a variable, that is m plus 3, because 4 ones are 4, 4 ones are 4 get cancelled. Remaining is m plus 3. Is equal to 18 by 4 because we are dividing on the both sides. I had reduced this fraction to the lowest term, so it is 9 upon 2. So m plus 3 is equal to 9 upon 2. Or we can say that m is equal to, see here, m is equal to, here we are going to do and transposing that it will go to the LHS to RHS, that is left hand side to right hand side. So here will be 9 upon 2. Here we are having a plus 3, it will go as a minus 3. Now when it is 9 upon 2 minus 3, we don't have anything in the remainder. So first we have to find the LCM, whatever the step required to find the get the solution. So here we had done at the equation, finding the LCM, we had tried to solve this 9 upon 2 minus 3 is 3 upon 2. Now we got the value of m as 3 upon 2. Okay, now how to check? Already in before two classes also I had told how to check by substituting the value of a variable, that what you have find out as a value of a variable is correct or not. By checking LHS, first LHS is this 4 whole m plus 3 is our LHS. Now we know the value of m is 3 upon 2. So we will substitute the value of m, that is in the place of m we will write as 3 upon 2 plus 3. Here also when it is an addition operation, we can't do directly because here we don't have anything in the denominator. It means that we are having 1. Try to find out an LCM and do it. So here it is 4 multiplied, it is a bracket here also. So we are writing here also 4 outside the bracket. So 4 multiplied by distributive property also we can use here, 4 multiplied by this first term, 4 multiplied by the second term. So what I done here is 4 multiplied by 3 upon 2 plus is my operation here. So here is 4 multiplied by second term, that is 3. By using a distributive property we have tried to solve this. So here if it is possible to reduce, when it is a multiplication, the word I am saying when it is a multiplication, then only you can reduce. So here is 2 ones are, here will be 2 twos are. So 2 multiplied by 3, here I had written 2 multiplied by 3 plus same operation, we are unable to change the operations. So here is 4 multiplied by 3, here is 4 multiplied by 3. Now you know this multiplication, 2 threes are 6 and 4 threes are 12, so 6 plus 12 is equal to 18 is our RHS. Left hand side we had find out this 18 is equal to 18 of RHS. So this is how we have checked that what value of a variable we had find out is correct or not, or in simple word we can say that LHS is equal to RHS. These are the some example. So we can find out this by different method. Now we will see some example related to our exercise, so you will understand. So we will go step by step by transposing the fractions or transposing the new numbers and how to solve. One example I will explain, then rest of the example we will try to solve. The first example, solve the following equation. The word is only to solve. So 2y plus 5 upon 2 is equal to 37 upon 2. You might be thinking it's very complicated, some equation is given. It's very easy. How to transpose and how to solve, I will say you. So it will be more easy than addition and subtraction on the both the side. Here 2y is having a variable, that is y is a variable. First we have to separate this. So we are having here 2y plus 5 upon 2 is equal to 37 upon 2. 2y we will take, this is implied sign. Last time also I told 2y is equal to whatever the fraction number we have to having, we have to write is 37 upon 2. Now we are going to transpose, so it is plus 5 upon 2 will be minus 5 upon 2. Only just there will be the change in the sign. So 2y is equal to, now it's very easy when both the denominators are same or are equal, so you can perform operations of addition and subtraction easily. So here 2, we are having both the denominator is 2, so we'll write as a 2 is a common here, and we will do the 37 minus 5, and you know what is 37 minus 5 is 32 upon 2. So 2y is equal to 32 upon 2. Now this is not a last step, we have to find out the value of an variable. So we will take a 2y separately if it is possible. When it is in the fraction form, when it is possible, you have to reduce. Here it is easy to reduce, here is 2 ones are, 2 16s are 32. So 2y is equal to 16. Y is equal to, now you know very well that when it is a multiplication and it is transposed, it will go in the division. So it will go in the denominator. So y is equal to 16 upon 2. This is nothing but we are dividing, or we are writing in the denominator. Again, when it is in the fraction form, if it is possible to reduce, you have to reduce to its lowest term. Here 2 ones are, 2 eights are 16. So y is equal to 8. When you might be finding it was some complicated equation, but we had find out the value of variable y is equal to 8. So in this way we have to transpose the from LHS to RHS and see this sign. If it is addition, it will change into subtraction, and if it is subtraction, it will change into addition. When it is the multiplication, it will change into division when you do the transpose. Here second example we will see, 5t plus 28 is equal to 10. Here t is a variable, so we will take this separately. So 5t is equal to 10 equal to whatever we are having, I told that you have to write equal to 10. Here we are having plus 28, we will go for minus 28, which is an transposing. So no need to write here, you are doing a transpose of an equation of plus 28 to minus 28. So here 58 is equal to, you know, 28 minus 10 is 18, but we had learned integer also, so we have to use the integer, that is the highest number is having a minus, so it will be a minus 18. So now here is multiplication, that is 5 multiplied by t, so it will go in the denominator, or we can say it will be divided. So t is equal to minus 18 upon 5 or divided by 5, both are same. So here it is not possible to reduce this fractional, so we will keep as it is, the t is equal to minus 18 upon 5. One more example we will see. A upon 5 plus 3 is equal to 2. You might be thinking it's very easy here. So A upon 5 plus 3 is equal to, take A upon 5 separately, equal to, right, 2 minus 3, because we are transposed here to the LHS to RHS. So A upon 5 is equal to, this is greater number, so we are writing as 3 minus 2 is 1 and minus 1. So A is equal to minus 1. Here we are having in the denominator, means it is in the division form. So we have to multiply, because it goes from LHS to RHS. So A is equal to, write as it is, minus 1 multiplied by 5. So A is equal to 5 ones are 5, but we are having as minus, so we have to write minus 5. So in this way we had find out the value of A as a variable when it was given in the form of an fraction. One more example we will see. Q upon 4 plus 7, Q upon 4 plus 7 is equal to 5. So Q upon 4, yes, we have written, because here we are having a variable equal to what we are having, the number as a whole is 5, equal to 5 transpose plus 7 will change into an minus 7. So Q upon 4 is equal to 7 minus 5 is 2, and greater number is 7, so it will be minus 2. Q is equal to minus 2, you can see here it is in the division, so it will go in the multiplication form. So multiplied by 4, so 4 2's are 8 is minus, so it is minus 8. So Q is equal to minus 8. Step by step we have to see. I had given a different types of example when it was in the multiplication form, when it was in the division form. One more example we will see, then we will go for the next. Here we are having 5 upon 2x is equal to 25 upon 4. You might be thinking it is only x is given here. It will always belong to a numerator. So it will be a 5x. So 5x upon 2 is equal to 25 upon 4. So what will it go? Right? 5x is equal to 25 upon 4. 25 upon 4, here it is in the division form, that is in the denominator. Now it will go in the numerator in the form of multiplication by 2. Now if it is possible to reduce when it is multiplied, so it will be reducible, you can reduce it to 1s are 2, 2s are 4. So here will be 25 upon 2, what will be this value? 5x is equal to 25 upon 2. Now we have to separate the variable. So x is equal to 25 upon 2, right, as it is. Here is a multiplication, so it will go in the division form or in the denominator. So we are writing here as 5. So here if it is possible to reduce here 5 ones are 5, 5s are 25. So x is equal to 5 upon 2. So here we are having some difference. step here where the x belongs to. So I have taken this example so you will understand how to do step by step how to find out the value of an variable. One more example which is somewhat different, so I will try to explain here, is 7m plus 19 upon 2 is equal to 13. 7m plus 19 upon 2 is equal to 13. Write that 7m is equal to, what is equal to, is 13. Here is plus, it will go as a minus. What we are doing, we are doing a transpose, so it will be 19 upon 2 as it is. So here 7m is equal to, now here you have to find out an LCM. You have to find, because here we are having 1, here that both the denominators are not same or equal, so we have to find the LCM. LCM is 2, then you know when the we are having the prime number in the denominator, you can directly multiply the denominator and you can find the LCM and you can do the cross multiplication, which I have already taught in the previous class. So here will be 26 minus 19, because here 13 twos are 26 minus 19 ones are 19 here upon 2. So 7m is equal to 7 upon 2. Here m is equal to 7 upon 2. Here is multiplication, so it will go in the division or it will in the form of denominator. So here 7 get cancelled, so what will be left is 1 upon 2. So m is equal to 1 upon 2. These are the questions given as equations by transpose. We can solve a different equations are there. So here we had seen maximum equation we have tried to solve. One more example we will solve here, so you will have a practice of this. So last, it is 2b upon 3 minus 5 is equal to 3. So when it is a variable, take it aside to the left hand side. So 2b minus 3 is equal to 3. Here is minus, it will be plus 5. So 2b upon 3 is equal to 8. Now 2b is equal to 8 multiplied by 3. So 2b is equal to 8, 3 is 24. B is equal to 24 upon 2. B is equal to, just reduced here, is 2 ones are 224. 2 12s are 24. So B is equal to 12. If you want to check, you can substitute the value of B here and you can see that is equal to 5, equal to 3. In this way, you can check by substituting the value of variable in the given equation. Now some more examples we are having as solve the following equations. Here it is very straight equation is given, 2 inside the bracket x plus 4 is equal to 12. I told when it is given in the bracket we have to consider whole and soul with a variable or whatever the number, whatever the operation is given, we have to take aside that bracket with an variable. So one example I will explain here is 2 inside the bracket x plus 4 is equal to 12. X plus 4 I have taken it separately because it is in the bracket form, whole and soul. Bracket is aside in the LHS, that is left hand side, equal to 12. Here is multiplication, so it will be in the division. So x plus 4 is equal to 12 upon 2, that is 12. 2 ones are 2, 6 are 12. So x plus 4 is equal to 6. What we had done? We had reduced here, but we had not got the value of x. We are having the value of x plus 4 is equal to 6. Now take the variable aside again into LHS, that is left hand side. X is equal to, what we are having after equal to sign is 6. Transpose this, plus will go in the minus 4. X is equal to 2. So what we had find out, the value of a variable x is equal to 2. Here wherever it is a bracket is given, we have to take it into and left hand side, or we can say it to the left hand side. So in this way we can take the whole bracket with a whatever the operation or whatever the number with a variable, and we have to first try to find out the steps, then we have, we can find out the value of an variable. So some more examples we will see here. Here it is 3 inside the bracket n minus 5 is equal to 21. Here we will take n minus 5 to the LHS equal to 21. Why we have written here 3? Because here it is multiplication, so it is written in the division. Try to reduce if it is possible, then 3 ones are 3 sevens are. So n minus 5 is equal to 7. Now separate the variable, n is equal to 7. Here is minus 5, it will be plus 5. N is equal to 12. In this way we had find out the value of an variable, n is equal to 12. One more example here, 3 inside the bracket n minus 5 is equal to minus 21. Very similar to this, only there is a change in a sign, that is equal to 21 to the RHS. Here we are having minus 21, which will give a difference, lot of difference we will see here. Take n minus 5, which is given in the bracket, to the LHS equal to minus 21 upon 3, because here it is multiplication, it will be. Try to reduce, after reduction we will get 3 ones are 3 sevens are, which is minus 7. So n minus 5 is equal to minus 7. So variable n is equal to, what is after equal to the minus 7 as it is, then transpose this, minus 5 will be plus 5, and n is equal to 7. One is positive integer, one is negative integer. So subtract the number and find the greater number sign. After subtraction, 7 minus 5 is 2, greater number is 7, which is having minus sign, so it is minus 2. So n is equal to minus 2. There was only change here in minus 21 and 21. See the difference, what will be the value we are getting when there is only simple change. If you might be thinking why to put sometime minus and plus sign, but it will give a lot of difference in the both the values. So in this way we had seen some more examples here today with transposing, and one more example if it is possible we will try to solve. 3 minus inside the bracket 2 inside the bracket 2 minus y is equal to 7. Take this separately because it is related, 2 is related with this bracket. So we are taking to our LHS equal to 7. We are having plus 3, so it will go as a minus 3. Here we will write as it is thus first, then we will solve this. 7 minus 3 is 4. 2y, 2 minus y, which is given in the bracket, that we will take to LHS equal to what it is, 4. Here is multiplication, minus 2 we will be here in the RHS, it will be in the division form, or we can say in the denominator, that is minus 2. Reduced, 2 ones are and 2 twos are 4. So we can say as 2 minus y is equal to minus 2. Now we want to find out the value of y. Y is having some sign with it. So minus y is equal to minus 2. Here is plus, so it will be here minus 2. Minus y is equal to minus, 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 and add the number is 4, that is 2 plus 2 is 4. So minus y is equal to minus 4. Minus minus get cancelled, so y is equal to 4. In this way we had tried to solve different type of examples with a different variables with a different equation, and hope so you have understood and try to solve some example related to the textbook which are very similar to it. So have a practice of this transposing the equations, and thank you very much.